Take my time walking out of the line. Hello! Do you mind just my lighting here? Hi, you haven't met me yet. I am Mr. Sullivan. I am the theater teacher here at Hickory Ridge, and I would like to thank you guys for coming out to our first 24-hour theater show in, 2 or 3 years. So it is a super exciting event, and I'm so grateful that we are back into the swing of things with it. So first and foremost, a little bit of housekeeping before I get into some of what the show is about and some of the stuff in your program. First new business, as always, of course, is please take these and put them into silent mode or airplane mode, whatever suits your fancy. Just, we don't want anybody's phone going off in the middle of the show. That was fake. If you want to take images or video, you are more than welcome. Nothing is copyrighted. That being said, if you do take a photo, please don't use flash. It distorts the actors and blinds your neighbors, which there might be something to say about that. Also, if you are interested in videoing, I will let you know that we actually have a video camera set up right back there. I will be videotaping the entire evening and then putting it up on our YouTube. So if you were like, boy, I want a video of this, but I also would like to actually like be in the moment and watch it, I got you. So, let me talk just a little bit about what 24-hour theater is. So 24-hour theater, we got together last night. We got together at 5 p.m. last night, and we had a little meeting, and I divided the groups into five directors with, I've divided them into five different shows, each one with a director, a playwright, and four or five actors. And so those directors and playwrights had a chance to meet with their actors, sort of talk to them about what they thought they were good at, and then they kicked the actors out. And then the directors and the playwrights had a moment to sort of talk to each other about what kind of show they thought they might want to do. And then the directors left. And then the directors and the actors got to like sleep last night. The playwrights didn't, because the playwrights had to write an entire show before 6 a.m. this morning. And then they had to email those plays to me by 6 a.m. this morning. So 6 a.m. this morning, I got a bunch of emails like, Sully, here you go. just these Monster / Red Bull adults, you know, team, just like, I think it's English. Do your best. So I went ahead and proofread them and made sure that nobody had fallen asleep on their keyboard for like 3 pages, and then printed them out. The playwrights showed up at 6:30 so that they had a chance to read through the scripts and make any adjustments that they felt were needed. And then the actors showed up at 7 a.m. this morning, and then we started rehearsing. So everything that you are seeing today was developed between 5 p.m. yesterday and 6 a.m. this morning in the heads of these playwrights, and then rehearsed from 7 a.m. until 5 p.m. today when we took our dinner break. And then you're getting to see the finished product. Now, obviously, it's a little rough because, again, they made it in 24 hours. So it's an incredible program. I love it. It's super exciting. And it's just good fun. It tends to be somewhat chaotic, but it's pretty fun. Surprisingly enough, most of them will be off book. I don't think anybody's on book. Now, they might have a little stumble here or there. But again, they've been rising 24 hours. Well, that's cool. But anyway, real quick, I want to point out in our program, there is a QR code right here, and it corresponds to a little bit about our backstage bulls. The backstage bulls are kind of our boosters, if you will. Now, we avoid the term boosters because a lot of people have a sort of negative connotation of that. They're like, isn't that a second job? And maybe it's some boosters. But the theater boosters, surprisingly, it's not as massively involved. There are a lot of volunteer opportunities when you come for like 2 hours. And a lot of the volunteer opportunities get you in to see a show for free. And there's so many different ways that you can help out that don't even involve any time. Sometimes it's just being part of the backstage bulls so that way you're in the loop and hear about the different things that we might need to borrow for props or set pieces. Where we're like, we really need an antique rocking horse. And we're like, I got a rocking horse sitting in my garage and been, you know, sitting there gathering cobwebs for 3 years. and you were on the list with the Backstage Bulls, you would know, and we'd be able to borrow it from you, and everybody would be, you know, super happy. And it's helping us out immensely without even having to really involve yourself with a lot of time or, you know, even money at that point. So if that is something that interests you in helping us out in some way, shape, or form, that QR code takes you to a Google form where you can give us your contact information and even click the different types of things that you might be interested in being involved with. So that way, we can like pull up who is interested in potentially doing front of house selling tickets and concessions. We can look at the people that said, I'm really interested in that. And if you're not interested in that, you wouldn't come up on it. So if that is something, please, 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 Backstage Bulls make my life easier. It makes it so that we can do all kinds of stuff. They are the lifeblood of this program, really. And then on the back, I've got all of our upcoming events. So we got a bunch of cool stuff going on. I'm gonna go real quick through it. We have a meeting next week. It is an informational meeting for those people whose students are either going into or would like to go into one of my honors theater programs. Those are typically my proficient, advanced, or tech advanced, or practicum, or independent study, or musical classes. So if you have a student that's going into one of those or is interested, I invite you to that meeting. It will be here next Wednesday. It will also be on Microsoft Teams. So if you're unable to make it, but would like to log on to Teams and just sort of listen in and maybe ask a question at the end if you got one, I would invite you to do that. I will also record it if you're like, I can't make Wednesday. I will record that and put it up on my webpage so that you can watch it at dinner. Then we've got a practical showcase in May 6th, which is student directors and our intermediate class doing bigger one act so that they have more time to rehearse. Honk Junior is our last musical of the season. We actually do too. Honk Junior is a one act musical that's done by my musical theater class. It's awesome. It's the story of the Ugly Duckling. That's music. We've got the Bloomy Awards. We participated in the Bloomies when we did Spamalot. And so the Bloomy Awards, they're the tickets go on sale. We will open that up to the students first, and then there will be a later link for parents if they would like to come with us. But it is essentially like going to see the Tonys, but for high school musicals. So it's pretty awesome. And then the International Thespian Society induction ceremony and awards night, which you don't have to be in the International Thespian Society to be a part of that, but many of your students may already have enough chance to be inducted. So if they're curious about that, have them talk to me or come to that meeting on Wednesday where I'll talk more about ITS. I swear I am pretty much done. The last thing that I need to do is make sure that you get your money's worth, because some people wanted some stars to shout out to their students for our first scene. So if you're backstage, these are for you. Good job, Jazz. I'm so proud of you. Kaylee, Milo, you are a star to us, the Whiteheads. Jazz, you are amazing. We love you, Mom, Dad, and Gee. Sarah, we know you will do great. Love, Soph, Mom, and Dad. Yeah. And I'm pretty sure that was right there, because now I'm terrified. So yes, it was awesome. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Trey, our first director. You will not hear from me again, except for read a few more of these stars in between. I swear I won't see you more. Thank you so much.
talking.
He made her wait while he went to the bathroom. Not to break to you, but that's kind of
It's kind of funny to see people get hurt,
right? Yeah, I guess you're right. It's kind of funny watching people fall. Yeah, it is. So, what about you? What do you do for free time?
Well, I usually paint. It's not as hardcore, but I do really enjoy it, and it passes the time.
Seriously? Painting? That's so lame. Don't worry. I'll make sure to get you into the cool stuff.
You!
Go, Cam! You're amazing! Great. your mom.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jenny Falcon, and welcome to the Friday Night.